Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest will celebrate their 30th wedding anniversary this upcoming Monday.
Yay!
Yes. They are relationship and career goals,
yes,
as they're the first married couple to preside over a daytime television courtroom. Let's take a look.
I know the difference between a good male friend and a horny male friend.
Okay.
You feel
you know
me?
The difference?
I know.
All right, do you know the difference?
I know the difference.
Yeah. All right. Do I have any horny male friends?
You better not.
No, have you seen that?
No, I have not, and I better not see it.
All right.
Look.
But
so
I trust you. I trust you.
You know, men know the difference.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
What does it
Ron,
look like?
You know the
yes,
difference.
Yes, sir. We know the difference.
Okay,
men
what does that look
difference.
Like?
We hear a lot about women's intuition, but, you know, men have a little common sense, too, right?
Little.
Yes.
Please welcome down, back down to the circle from Cutlers Court with the Cutlers, Judges Dana and Keith Cutler.
Yes!
Thank you.
Yes!
My God, y'all got into a whole conversation down,
right,
down to the
that's
show.
That's what we do now here.
That's what we're doing right now.
I know.
So, 30 years of marriage is,
yes,
coming this Monday.
Yes.
My God, how do you plan to celebrate?
Yes. Well, we're kind of doing, we're celebrating our 30th year. We're like, this is too big to just do for one day.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So we're bucket list things. So we came to the Super Bowl here in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to go to, yes, I am that kind of football fan. We're going to the Football Hall of Fame this,
yes,
year.
Yes.
And then
we're going to take a cruise. We're going to take,
okay,
a cruise to the Greek Isles.
Oh,
wow.
Kind of round out the year. So it's been,
yeah,
a year celebration. We've been married for 30 years. We've been together for 37.
Nice.
So,
wow.
It's a beautiful thing.
It is.
It's
it
a
is.
Friendship, you know, and on your show, you give advice to so many people. But who pours into you as a couple?
You know, I would say it's our parents. It was modeled for us.
Mm-hmm.
My parents are celebrating 55 years,
yes,
in August. Keith's parents, they've gone to glory,
mm-hmm,
but they were married
37 years before my mother passed away.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's what's been modeled for us.
Yeah.
And, mm-hmm, you know, we kind of feed off of each other. The thing is, we want to be together.
Yeah.
You know, I tell any couple, as long as you want to be together,
man,
you'll be together.
You'll figure it out.
Right. So, Selena, we saw them say, he said to her, what's up, before the interview started. I was like, that's something that Kiwan and Smitty would do, right?
Yeah.
Like, we on the right path.
We
all good.
So, why is he clowning me? That's what I want to know.
I'm not clowning you. We're feeling each other.
Oh, is that what this is?
Yeah.
Is this me feeling you?
Yeah, that's what
I whatever, man.
Yes.
Well, congratulations on your second daytime Emmy.
Yeah.
Nomination. I want you to be able to say that one
day. We're going to speak it.
Yeah.
Amen.
We're
going
to speak,
yeah,
it. So, your second daytime Emmy.
Yes.
Okay, we're going to speak it. And now that you've gotten your feet wet in television, how do you like the experience? Do you think that it increases the strength of your marriage, or does it actually cause a little friction at any time?
Oh, no.
I don't think it causes friction. I think anytime we're doing something together because we enjoy each other's company,
mm-hmm,
anytime we're doing something together, we make fun of it. We,
yeah,
have a good time with it. And so, you know, the television show, whether we're out hanging with friends,
mm-hmm,
whatever we're doing together, we make it a good time.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Has there been something that was too weird, though, with the fame that you have now?
We've had some interesting encounters with our fans,
mm-hmm,
and it still surprises me that people are like, and I'm like, who are you looking at? Yeah. I want to see who you looking at, and they're looking,
yeah,
at me. That's kind of weird. We've had some, you know, interesting people come up on us. I recently we had someone approach me, and I was like, he's a little crackish looking to me.
Oh, my God!
And so, but, you know, I mean,
yeah, yeah. Hey, if he watches the show, more power,
yeah,
to him.
Yeah, I was, yeah, like, you, yes, know, we can have a fan like that, but,
yeah,
I was like, you are a little different.
Yeah.
I wouldn't expect you to be in our...
But, you know, overall, our fans have been great.
Look, yeah.
You know, everybody's
look
wonderful.
Look at him recovering.
Right.
It is. That's true.
Yeah.
Everybody's been really wonderful, and,
yeah,
we've been enjoying the ride. I hope it continues.
Right. Yeah, mm-hmm,
right, right.
Yeah.
So, I mean, a lot of times the couples that you minister to are, well, not minister to, they, I guess, preside over.
Well,
yeah,
minister
to, yeah,
yeah.
It's infidelity. Lots of,
yeah,
infidelity.
Mm-hmm.
What type of advice do you find yourself giving to these couples who, you know, go through this all the time?
You know, it depends. You know, I really am careful with married couples. I don't want to break up a marriage, you know, and that's the better for worse. It can't get much worse than your spouse stepping out on you.
Right.
But like a young couple, I'm like, and not a whole lot of time in it, no kids, I'm like, you know what? Y'all might need to kick rocks from each other and go find the right person. So it just depends. It really does.
Yeah.
And the situation.
It also depends. Was it one time? Was it a serial thing? Mm-hmm. I mean, each case is different.
Yeah.
We just listen to what the litigants tell us. We look at the evidence. And then we try to figure out what's the best advice to give them.
What's been the worst case you've seen?
Yeah.
The worst case. The couple that had, where the lady had sex the day of the show. It's like,
was single other than her husband.
Oh, it's like, dude, do you know why you're here?
The morning they were appearing in court.
Yes. Oh, she tripping.
Yes. Yeah. I'm like, you don't know why, what.
Yeah, you. She trying to lose.
Yeah, you miss the purpose for being here.
Right.
Yeah.
We're like,
my goodness.
Yeah, that was kind of like the one where we were like, and I think the other one was where the husband, we said, who do you want to be with, your wife or your girlfriend?
Mm-hmm.
And he actually went,
Oh.
Yeah, it took some time to think about it.
Like, she makes good pork chops, but her brisket's really slamming.
Oh, my God.
He's weighing the pros and cons when I'm throwing him a softball question.
Yes.
You know?
And then he finally said, okay, my wife. And we were like, wrong.
Yeah, lucky her, right?
Yeah.
I'd be like, you good.
You real good. You're and that's what she did.
Good. What type of advice do you give to your three sons just about success and being able to find the right person to be like this? It's just all that type of advice.
Well, you know, at raising three sons, I try to teach them how to treat women.
He did.
You know, how to treat a woman, how to be respectful and, you know, be the man of your household, but still, you know, properly treat a woman. So I hope they have been listening, hope they know what's going on. So far, they've proven that they have.
Okay, good.
And just find the right person. You know, don't rush into anything. Just find the right person who fits you.
Yes, good. All right. Well, thank you so much.
You've had so much fun.
Yes.
We'll come back and play.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Open invitation down to the circle.
There you go.
To make sure you watch this amazing couple on Couples Court TV, you can go to couplescourttv.com or check your local listings for When Couples Court with the Cutlers is airing in your city. Can we give it up for this amazing couple?